a tablet. No, you are not seeing things. Yes, this is Android. I picked this tablet up for $130 off Walmart's website. Now, why would I buy a $130 tablet? Well, because personally for me, if it was junk at $130, I don't feel like I've completely got screwed over. Biggest difference, this is a 1.2 gigahertz rock chip processor. If you know your tablets and your processors, that's a decent processor. It's not great. 512 RAM, so about what my Samsung Continuum has for RAM. And it's got 4 gigs of SD, you know, internal memory, which it doesn't really bother me that much because of one of the nice little features that I'll talk about in a minute. This is running on a 7-inch screen, 800 by 480. You got a 0.3 megapixel webcam right there with built-in mic, so you can take your video. On the bottom, you have your 32 gig expandable micro SD, so that gives you a total of 36, which is the nice feature that I liked. Your mic, USB, your reset button, headphone, and mini HDMI connection. Now, that's the tech specs. Build quality is actually, for a tablet of this kind, I was expecting quite junk. I was actually pleasantly surprised that the build quality is actually fairly sturdy. There's screen flex and stuff that you'll notice, but I've had other tablets and that's pretty much a known issue with them. That being said, for $130, spend $30-$40 on a 32 gig micro SD card, 36 gigs, you got plenty of local and hosted content. Screen size is where I like it. For ebooks and Netflix and what have you, it works perfectly fine. The touch screen is actually really fairly responsive. Obviously, this is taking up a few more processes because I'm using Go Launcher EX instead of the default Gingerbread, and that gets me into the cons. One of the cons is you can tell this is a cell phone OS. First thing you'll notice over by your clock here is no service. Well, no crap, I'm not running on a phone. Another thing you'll notice, defaultly, seeing how this is running a different launcher, you're stuck in landscape mode. You can't go to portrait mode in your default view, which is kind of annoying. The app market comes with Amazon App Store, which I have no problem with, except the selection is not that good. So I downloaded a recommended app market called One Mobile Market, and I will give you guys a view on that. The viewing angles obviously are more webcam oriented than anything else, but that's what your app market there looks like. It's got about 200,000 apps, so it's a great replacement for the Android market. For $130, I mean, you can get 36 gigs of storage without the lock-in to Amazon completely, like the Kindle. You get your 7-inch tablet. You can root this. There's a program called Gingerbread. That you can find the APK for, and you can root this if you want. I've rooted it, but I haven't installed any other mods. So, there's just a quick review, guys. Netflix works on it. Great performance. The touchscreen is actually very responsive. So, for probably about $170, you can get a 36 gig, decent 7-inch tablet with your Kindle apps and all that crap. So, what the hell? Go get it. You guys know what to do. Rate it, subscribe.